What is up, my YouTube friends? Today I have a widget that changes everything. With it, you can select comments from chat to add to your live stream overlays in OBS. It works with YouTube, Facebook, and Twitch. You're gonna absolutely love this app. So let's get to it. My analytics say that 80% of the folks that watch my content are not subscribed. Am I doing something wrong? If so, let me know in the comments. But if you are looking for tools, tips, and tricks that can help make you a better YouTuber or live streamer, subscribe to the channel and click that bell so you don't miss any new content. This app is so epic and it's totally free. The first thing I'm gonna do is show you how to download and install it properly on your PC. Second, I'm gonna walk you through how to set it up in OBS and for all the platforms. Last, I'm gonna show you how to use it and also how to customize everything in the app to get the exact look that you want. Now first, I should give a big thanks for Zach to creating this epic app for us for free. It's guys like this that make the streaming community an awesome place. So thanks, Zach. There's a link to this app in the description so you can download it and follow along with us. It's the best way to learn and it's totally free. So why not? Let's install it. You're gonna wanna click the link in the description and it's going to bring you to this page here and you can just click get. And this is gonna ask you if you wanna open the Microsoft Store. Now the app is free, so it's not a problem to open this. So I just click open Microsoft Store. Takes a couple of moments for Microsoft Store to open. Once you get here, you click get, then you click install, and it's gonna download from the Microsoft Store. Once it's all installed, you can just click launch. It's gonna ask you to allow access. And this is for it to use your network and just click allow access. Once you do that, you have Twidget installed. That was super easy. Let's get into OBS and get it all configured up. After you install it, you're gonna come up to this screen here and you're just going to click connect to Google. You're gonna go ahead and choose your Google account and it's gonna bring you to the Twidget wants to access your Google account. You're going to wanna select the box view your YouTube account and then click continue. And once you're done, it'll give you the all clear. Logged into Twidget Success, and if you minimize that, you can see that Twidget is now up and ready to go. So if we click this start, we can see how to add the live streams that we want to connect to. And what I'm going to do here is connect to Facebook. And you'll have to do this anytime you live stream to Facebook. It doesn't keep this connection. And I'm going to go ahead and just log into my Facebook account right here and continue as me. And once that's finished, we're all set and ready to go. Now you're gonna notice you don't have to do any connection to Twitch whatsoever. So now we're set up and ready. Still says it's connecting to Facebook in the background, but we're pretty much already connected. And there you go. So now we're ready to stream all three of these. If we go into information, we can go into OBS setup and it tells us exactly how to set this up, but let me walk you through it. We'll go into OBS and we're gonna click the plus in our scene that we're gonna live stream under. We're gonna go to browser and I'm just gonna call this browser chat and I'm gonna click okay. And here I'm going to paste in localhost colon 3000 /source and I'm gonna change the width to 450 and the height to 500. And I'm gonna leave the custom CSS the same for now. And I'm just gonna scroll down here and I'm going to click refresh browser when scene becomes active. And then I'm gonna click okay. So now our widget is all set up. We wanna create a browser dock for our widget. So I'm gonna go into view, then docs, and then select custom browser docs. And right here, I'm just going to type chat so that we know which dock we're talking about. And over here, it's gonna be localhost colon space 3000 /, and it's not actually going to be source here, it's going to be dock. And I'll fix that in a second, but I'm just gonna move it over here and dock it up. And then I'm gonna just fix this. And click apply and then close. And now it's all set. We're gonna be able to see all of our chats here from anything that we stream to. Here you can see that I've set up to stream to Facebook, Twitch, over there on the right using the multiple outputs widget, and then YouTube. So I'm going to stream to all three at once to show you that all three of the different chats will show up and be selectable. Now I don't generally recommend streaming to multiple platforms at the same time. I know a lot of people like to do it, but it's hard enough to be successful on one platform at a time, streaming to three different ones. ones doesn't give you the ability to really learn how to do any one very well. But I'm gonna show you how to do it just in case you want to. So we have all three started and broadcasting. You can see these two are broadcasting here, and down in the bottom, the green dot says that I'm broadcasting to YouTube as well. So now I'm going to go over into Twidget and I'm going to click on start. And we just have to collect our connections right here. So first I'm gonna go into YouTube. I'm gonna click this little share button and collect the actual location for our stream. And I'm gonna put it right in here. Next, I'm gonna go into my Facebook live stream and I'm going to collect the actual URL up here at the top. I'm gonna paste that in here. And last but not least, I'm going to go into Twitch and collect the URL for my live stream and paste it right here and click connect. And now we have all of our chats loaded in here. You can see the ones I've already created on YouTube. I can go in here and click select and turn them on and off. I can go into Facebook, type something in the chat, and then when I go back into OBS, you can see it shows up. I can select it and it will appear on the stream. And of course, last but not least, we can do the exact same thing here in Twitch. So this lets you see all of your chats right in OBS and select any individual chat and show it on your screen. We'll go back into OBS and select it, and there we go. So all three of our chats are functional at the exact same time. There is one more cool thing you can do. I'm gonna go ahead and click the plus and add another browser overlay. We're gonna call this one overlay and I'm gonna click OK. Then I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna put localhost colon space 3000 / chat flow. And I'm gonna change the width to 400 and the height to 1080. Now I'm going to refresh the browser when the source becomes active. And I'm gonna leave the custom CSS the same again. I'm gonna click OK and move this over to the right. And what this is going to be is a chat overlay for all of our chats. So I've basically killed all the other live streams except for my YouTube one because it's just easier to show as an example. And now I'm gonna just put some text in here, and I have horrifyingly bad spelling. That is one thing we know for sure. And there we go. Now we put a chat in our YouTube. We'll go back over and you can see in the chat overlay, it shows that. And it will show chat to anything that you have set up. So Twitch, YouTube, or Facebook, they'll all show up in that overlay on the right, which helps your audience see who you're talking to in case they're on one platform or the other, which is nice to have that overlay. And you can see when I went over here and tried to go ahead and add the chat directly to the stream, it didn't work. So I'm gonna re-add this in here. I noticed this happening when I add the chat overlay in, so I just removed, re-added the chat, applied it, and now our chats are working just fine. And like I said, I highly recommend you have this chat overlay in here if you are going to stream to multiple platforms. That way your audience can see all of the chat from all the different platforms and communicate with one another by realizing that it's just going to show up on your live stream, which is absolutely fantastic. So there we go. Now it's shown up on our live stream and we can add it directly in. Epic. Now I'm gonna show you how it works and how you can customize it. To use the different presets, we just go over here into the main Twidget window. And we just click this little slider. It brings up the OBS chat templates. We can go down here and select. It has some different ones for super chat and super sticker templates. But up at the top, it has all different kinds of templates that we can use for our chat. So let's select dark and we can come back over here and we can add our text in, and you can see it gives it a dark format. We can select edge and there we go. You can see what that one looks like. Minimalist. And that's pretty cool. And then the classic, which I really like. I think that looks absolutely fantastic. But if you don't like any of the presets, well, you're not necessarily stuck with them, especially if you know how to use CSS. And let me show you how you can create your own custom ones. So what I'm gonna do here first is I wanna go into Twidget, and I just wanna make sure that we have clean selected. Once you have clean selected in your main widget, we can go over into our OBS and select chat. I'm gonna right click and go to properties. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna change my width to 550 and change my height to 550 for this custom CSS. And then where it says custom CSS, I'm just gonna write over this some custom CSS that was already written for me, and everything else stays the same. And there you go. I can put a link to this file in the description if you want to try this custom CSS. And so now we'll just drag this up so we can see it. And if we select it, you can see it even has some animations. It's very, very cool. Put some kind of rainbow over top the logo and it bounces in and bounces out. And that's cool. It's probably not my style, but it's meant to show you the kind of things that you can do with custom CSS if you wanted to set these up. Now, we're probably not all custom CSS masters, so I'm going to leave a link in the description to Zach's email, and according to him, you can just go ahead and message him if you want some custom CSS done up for your live stream overlays so that you can make them look unique to your live stream. What an epic app! If you want to see how you can let your audience change scenes in your live streams, you should check this video out. And if you're always looking for tools, tips, and tricks that can help make you a better YouTuber or live streamer, subscribe to the channel. It's totally free. My name is Michael Fire Jr. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.